we work with housing, but we also work to help people reach their dreams. And a lot of that is financial literacy. What we discovered in the process of doing home ownership counseling and education is that we also needed some resources to help people get where they wanted to go. Well, we could tell them about it, but what can you do? We don't have money. So that meant we had to try to think of ways to put money with that. And so another thing that we do is we work with what's called the Metropolitan Area Continuum of Care for the Homeless. But every time we came together, one of the things that we kept discovering is that we people always
next, an iTeam exclusive. What happens to Nebraska foster children when the state stops paying?
Me out. That cut off my medical insurance. That stopped paying for school.
A harsh new reality for that teenager, and she's not alone. Next, a new program to help bridge the gap.
Plus, an Iowa teen. Foster children wait so long to find a place to call home.
Those who don't find one find themselves aged out and on their own at age 19.
New tonight, iTeam investigator Christy Anderson shows you one teenager struggle and a new effort to help other teens make a fresh start.
So much, please. Thank you.
It's just a small one-bedroom apartment, but to Diane Nunez, it's a symbol of hope. Just 3 months ago, she didn't have a home. She hopped from couch to couch.
And wondering, well, where am I going to stay tonight? Maybe my friend, you know, so-and-so will let me stay here. No, I don't want to bother her.
Diana is one of many Nebraska foster children who age out of the system every year at age 19 and find themselves stuck.
When they aged me out, that cut off my medical insurance, that stopped paying for school.
Something that I do for my kids, you know, they have to kind of do on their own.
Julia Craig is the coordinator of a new program called Opportunity Passport, a partnership between the Family Housing Advisory and the Nebraska Children and Families Foundation, a program helping these young adults fill the gap when the state stops paying.
Help the youth get a boost up to kind of get those opportunities that they probably are lacking that the parents are not providing.
Opportunity Passport provides financial education and also an incentive to save. For every $1,000 the youth save, Opportunity Passport matches it with another $1,000.
They can use that for housing if they need an apartment. They can use it for medical expenses. They could use it for education.
And if they're saving for a vehicle, which sponsors say is a huge need, Opportunity Passport pays even more.
I was able to save my own $1,000 and they would give me $4,000. It's a 4-to-1 match. So, I mean, that helps with 2 or 3 car payments. That gets my plates, all my insurance.
But more than that, it gives these young adults hope that things will be okay. Not just now, but far into the future.
I think once we do have families, they're going to have it. The children will have it a lot easier than we did. And, you know, they'll love life.
In Omaha, Christy Anderson, KETV News Watch 7.
Opportunity Passport just received more funding, so the pilot program will continue.